next guest predicted an attack on the World Trade Center, as well as the global financial crisis and the success of Apple's iPod, but he's not psychic. Philosopher Dr. Richard Haymes has been described as the most accurate futurist in the world, and he joins us now to share his vision of the next decade. It's nice to see you, Richard. Hey. Thank you for being here. This is fascinating. So you actually predicted those hijacked planes being flown into the World Trade Center.
Yeah.
How do you make these predictions? How do you see into the future?
Yeah, it's a big crystal ball. No, joking. It's a very rigorous method, actually. We use AI now, artificial intelligence, to help us scan hundreds of millions of documents that are available in the public domain online. And then we use about 3,000 trusted sources around the world to give us insights and input. And then we picture some scenarios, different scenarios, and make predictions within those worlds.
So you're like a data-driven Nostradamus.
Are you... Nostradamus is a difficult one because he was so vague.
If you predict enough things, sooner or later one of them will be...
That's right.
What made you think September 11, though, would actually... Yeah. The attack on the World Trade...
No date to it. We were doing a project with security intelligence organisations in the UK and the US, and we were asked to look at the likelihood of domestic terrorism, and so that was one in a number of targets that we said is pretty obvious that could be demolished in some
way. I'm going to say something that sounds silly, but I genuinely believe it. I think the movie Independence Day, where they were blowing up buildings, where the alien spaceships were blowing up buildings, I saw that and I thought, someone is going to try to do that. The image of it is so terrifying that someone who really wants to scare the bejesus out of a city or a nation will try to replicate that.
Isn't it weird how movies very often predict what will happen?
Yeah.
Now, I'm not... I'm going to regret asking this, but I have to ask it anyway. You are predicting that Donald Trump will be re-elected in 2020. Mm. Why?
There's no alternative. The Democrats are in disarray. Unless they choose Kamala Harris and he loses so much support from his base, then the Democrats are in with a chance. Otherwise, no way.
No one's strong enough. Yeah. No, there's
and will the world survive Donald Trump for another 4 years?
Oh, yes. He's just hastening the kind of collapse that needs to happen anyway, I think. So I think he's quite good for us.
Well, you mentioned is it a lady?
Kamala Harris.
Now, is she the one that says she wants to be elected without any money and she wants to give the American people 10 votes?
I haven't heard that, but possibly.
Yeah, no, I saw her in a...
She's the former prosecutor of California.
Yes, that's right. Mm.
Mm. Yeah,
She's in the progressive wing of the Democrats. Yeah. And so it's seen that, and you're absolutely right, I agree with you. She's the only one who can energise the sort of far-left Democratic base enough to get the momentum she needs, but she then won't be able to pull middle Americans with her.
Anyway, the important stuff. What about Facebook? Is that going to be around for a long time?
No. I mean, so it's done a lot of damage already. It's continuing to do a lot of damage. People are leaving it already. There's the litigation litigants lining up now to sue for one thing or another. And they will rebrand into probably something they own, like Instagram, but in 10 years' time, we'll forget about it all.
What about social media generally?
Social media is going to increase and is going to result in much more surveillance in society generally.
Mm. And you also predicted capitalism will collapse.
Yeah. This is a longer term. There are signs that this is happening already, but the two things that will indicate a real collapse are when we start to challenge the whole notion of growth at any cost, and we start also to consider how to put a cap on the accumulation of individual wealth.
Mm. Right.
Because that will strike at the very heart of capitalism.
Now, we're all ordinary people. We're not millionaires, billionaires, whatever.
Yeah.
How is this going to affect us as just normal people?
Oh, it's such a good question. We don't know, do we? Half of us are asleep all the time. We really don't know what's going on in the world at a deeper level.
Mm.
So what concerns me is that we're so asleep, so disengaged with the political process that things happen without us really knowing what is going on.
Until it's too late.
Until it's too late. And I think that is a huge problem.
What are the other big kind of big predictions you have for the next decade? What can we be looking out for?
You mean the collapse of capitalism isn't a big
one? Well, and I'm pretty horrified by the Facebook prediction, but are we looking at flying cars? I mean,
yes,
in terms of the technology, are we always going to be addicted to our phones? I hate that. But what are some of the other big predictions you have?
The big prediction is the context that we're in, the context for change, all change. Mm. And we seem to be in a transition between the industrial world, the industrial paradigm and that way of working, to a different kind of society where we're developing a different kind of relationship with each other and with the planet, which we need in order to be able to survive. And so I think we're moving from an industrial world to a more empathic, connected world where things will be a lot different. But in the meantime, systems are going to collapse and we're going to feel very uncomfortable.
Are you hopeful for the future?
So yes. Hang on, I've got
I'm
to
hopeful,
ask.
I'm optimistic.
Oh, good.
What would you do if you're about to retire and you've got your superannuation fund? What do you do with that?
And hide.
Is it?
Go under the ground.
The revolution's coming, Denise.
But it worries me that if you talk about economic things, if the banks go down, then you've got money in the bank, you end up with nothing.
I don't have the answer to that, Denise.
Hang on, you got all the bloody data.
No.
You're saying Trump is going to get back in office. Come on, help her with her superannuation.
I'm no good. I'm the last person to ask for that kind of thing.
Didn't you do well with your super, Doug?
No.
Oh, never mind.
How about Bitcoin?
Yeah, that won't go away. Oh. That's going to go up. In 10 years' time, it'll possibly be 200,000. Oh, it's going to go up.
Wow. Oh. So, hang on, I put my super into the Bitcoin.
No. Maybe talk to your accountant
before
you do anything.
It's very volatile.
Can I say, Richard, you could have told me that privately.
And, and most importantly, do you think The Bachelor will choose Ellie?
You know, I live in a Thailand and I haven't a clue what goes on in television.
Oh, lucky you.
Yeah.
Dr. Richard Hames, thank you so much for joining us.
Good stuff. Really good.